Good evening, welcome. My name is Obindako. Welcome. I want to share with you tonight briefly what I call skill set, important skills you need for your business, important skills that you need for your business. The very few years, the very few times that I have tried to, you know, put an idea together and see if a business can come out of it, try to develop anything, I've come to see that there are a lot of skills, you know, there are a lot of skills that you need, but I'm looking at some of the most critical ones that can help any of us. And the ones I've identified, I think are important for anybody. Because the good thing is that there are a lot of people who are trying to do something for themselves, you know, who are trying to do something. You know, there are a lot of people who are selling products on Facebook, on Instagram, on WhatsApp. There are people who are developing, you know, either they are picking somebody's product, selling it, whether they have their own product that they are working on. There are a lot of these young guys who are developing applications. There are people who are developing, you know, websites. There are people in photography, media. There are a lot of things that I think a lot of our youth, a lot of our young men across Africa are involved in. And I think that the more you know as to the journey that you have embarked on, the better you are placed to win, and the better you are placed to at least see what will come out. Because the reality is that after 10 years, just about 1-2% of the businesses that people start will still be in existence. A lot of them will fail. And if they fail, it's okay. You know, can you try another one? I think that it takes a lot of effort for anybody to start a business and to keep going. I think that a lot of people will start and fail, struggle, start and fail, struggle, and then maybe somewhere along the line, they will then succeed. Why? Because the skill set that is really needed, the skills that are really needed for anybody to succeed, most of us were not, you know, born with it. And then we did not probably have a background that would at least help us to, you know, get this. So you are going to have them as you are going, and you get to a point where you have them in a very realistic measure, then you start to see the progress, then you start to understand what you're doing. And so some of the skill set, because what it takes, or what it will take for anybody to start a business in our country, in Ghana, in Africa, to succeed, I think it will be very much different from another country where, let's say, they are giving maybe your credit is 3% a year, where maybe the tax laws are good and they work for you, and they can give you grace period to fail, to try, to, you know, where the idea that you have completed school and you have to have a good job from a big organization in the very first year that you completed school, and that if you don't have that, it means the school that you went was useless. Those kind of ideas, in situations where those ideas are minimal, I think that people can succeed with their business. I am of the opinion that there's no point for anybody in this time of ours for anybody to just sit down and wait for somebody to help them or to employ them. And if that employment is not coming, it means that they can do anything. No, there are skill sets. There are skills that you can work on and you can help yourself. So number one skill that I would want to talk about is determination. You have to be determined. You have to have that. You have to know that, okay, I have started this business, or I want to start this business, or this business I've started, or this business I'm doing, I am determined to make sure that it works. You have to have that. A lot of people relative in terms of their thoughts or even in terms of what they want to do with their lives. There are so many people with so many options, so many people with plan Bs. You know, so he starts a business, then he wants to do something else, he wants to do something else, he wants to do. If you have so many options, you are not going to succeed. And so if you are in a business, at least give yourself a specific time that for the next 4 or 5 years, I want to give all my energy to this idea, to this business. And I want to make sure that it works. You have to have that kind of determination. You have to have that kind of momentum. You have to have that kind of drive. If you don't have that, and what I've seen is that a lot of people who you talk to don't have that kind of determination. They just want to just live their simple life and, you know, if the business works fine, if it doesn't. No, you need that determination. You have to be determined that I want to make sure that this business will work. It's a skill. Not many people are that determined to win. Not many people are that determined to succeed with their business. Not many people. So if you have that kind of determination, you know, you are determined and you are looking at yourself, you must have that mind that I want to win. Because there will be so many people who advise you anyway. There'll be so many people who you look up to, who seem like they know what they are talking about, very intelligent. Sometimes you think that they're very much successful, rich, who may never have gone through what you're going through as you build a business. And so if you're not that determined, those people will give you a lot of advice, you know, and eventually you will lose that focus. So you need that determination. If you're not determined, you probably will have to stop and go and look for it before you start. You need that. And determination, I think, also comes from a certain level of understanding that you have got to have on yourself, of yourself. You have to know the kind of personality, the kind of person that you are. What are your aspirations? What are the things that you want to do with your life? If business is part of it, then, you know, the more you understand yourself, the more you know what you want to do with your life, the more you know where you want to go with your life, the more determined that you would want to be. And so you have to have that. It's a skill set. If you don't know, if you don't have that, it will be very difficult for you to focus on that business. You need that. You need that. Most people who are trying to start business will be thinking about a lot of other things, but I am particular about this. If you don't have determination, there will be so many things that will just let you give up. So many things that will let you stop. You meet so many people who have fantastic ideas, beautiful ideas, who have a lot of things that they have written down, but they don't have that determination. They don't have that. And if you don't have that, you have no business. Starting a business is a skill set. If somebody has determination, you'll be the one with a lot of intelligence who has no determination. The other one that you will need is the courage to take that step, or to the courage to keep going. You need that. Business is about risk. There are a lot of things that you will not be able to know. No matter how intelligent you are, no matter how mature or thoughtful, or how much you think you understand what you're doing, there will be some element of risk. Because not everything depends on you. There are things that depend on other people's decisions and choices. There are things that depend on the country's decision, what happens to the country. There are things that nobody controls. There are so many things in this world that nobody controls. And those then bring what they call risk. And if you don't have courage, if you don't have the boldness, the courage does not mean that you don't see the danger. The courage does not mean that you are crazy and you're blind. No, the courage just means that, yes, you are taking this, and anything that comes out of this decision that you're making, you are ready to deal with it. You're ready to solve it as it comes around. You know, you're ready to go and keep going. And if anything comes up, you are ready to deal with it. That's courage. You want to see, okay, if I don't take this decision, if I don't take what they call risk, what are the things that I'm going to lose? Because what really helps the people who seem to have some bit of courage is that which they think they are going to win by taking this decision. They become so much, you become so much obsessed with the thought, you know, with the thought. You become so much with the victory. You become so much, okay, I'm starting this concrete business. I'm starting this construction business. Everything shows that I will fail. But I want to see myself as a business owner. And that thing alone will keep you going. That thing alone will keep you driving. If everybody thinks that, oh, you will not see. Why? Because you're looking at, okay, the next 2 years, the next 3 years, the next 4 years. God, thank you. The next 5 years. If I win with this business, maybe I'll be able to have money. Maybe I'll be able to employ people. Maybe I'll be able to build something. Maybe I'll be able to become, you know, I'll be known of having something that I've also been able to build with myself. You know, that thing really is what separates those who seem to have some kind of courage and the rest. The rest are focused on the losses. They're focusing on if I lose, if I don't win, if I don't get it, what will happen to me? The other ones who win, you think the footballers who are playing, they don't know that they can break their leg? They know. But they also know that if they win, something significant will change in their lives. And so if you are, and part of it is with the kind of background, the kind of upbringing that a lot of us have had. If you were, when you were growing up, if you came out, it came from a family where a lot of decisions were made for you. And your thoughts were never sought. Nobody trusted in your intelligence. Nothing was entrusted to you to be responsible and to even be given opportunity to make mistake. You know, if a lot of us were just groomed, protected, you know, we were protected from mistakes, from danger, from errors, from everything. So we have become 40 years, we have become 30 years, but we don't so much believe in our ability to take decision and be ready for the ramifications. That has a lot to do, you know, your upbringing. And then the total culture. If you meet your friend, he's asking you, Charlie, where do you work? If you meet your other friend, so are they here? Where are you there? Those kind of cultural group thinking, I think, has destroyed a lot of people's courage to start business, you know, because you need that. And if you're in business already, you cannot expect to think like everybody. I still think that you're going to succeed. You probably have to think opposite a lot of the general thoughts that people have, you know, because people will ask you. Like for instance, if you have you have a phone, but you have a business idea, or you have something that you think you have to sell to help you to succeed in your business, or you have a car, you see that, okay, this car, if I sell it, I'll be able to have a capital to start this business. The general perception will be, Master, what is your car? Why are you in the trotro? Somebody will even ask you, I don't know them for me. You know, those those kind of things. If you don't have an independent mind, if you have not developed yourself, you cannot. So it's a skill set that you need, courage to take risk, because everything is about risk in terms of business. Every decision that you're making, no matter how much you know, something else will happen. Every business that for instance, most people start businesses with this idea, you know, I want to sell bread, and they start to maybe go and buy the bread and put it on your table to sell. After 3-4 years, they may have started with bread, but they may end up selling something different. Why? What is important about business is you starting, and what you need to start anything is all this, the courage. You need that courage. You need that belief in yourself. That's why they say that entrepreneurs seem to have that some level of self-assurance, self-confidence. Why? Because it's without that, you don't have courage. And if you don't have courage, you would want to go with what everybody thinks. And if you think like everybody, you cannot be different. And if you are not different, then you don't know your value. You know, if you are not different from what everybody thinks, you don't know your value. And if you don't know your value, you cannot dare. If you are questioned, you will not be able to defend. If everybody is standing up, do you have a reason to stand up, or you want to sit? It's courage. And it's courage is what gives comfort, and it gives you calmness. You know, so determination. Yes, you need courage, you need determination. And the other one that you will need in part is as part of this skill set is people skills. You need that. You need that. You're not going to succeed with your business if you don't know how to work with people. How to be able to identify who has the skill that you need. Because there's always something that somebody has that you don't have. If you don't have that knack to see and to be able to connect and group people, put teams together, and lead them to accomplish a mission, to accomplish a course, you struggle with your business. You need that. And it's about the most complex element in the skill set. People. Can you pick a Ghanaian who has a graduate, who has a degree, and lead him? Become your employee. He comes with no skill. And at the end of 2 years, 3 years, he knows something. Would he still stay with you? Do you have the ability to know what to say to know what to say to somebody for them to be part of this? People skill, you need that. Your ability to even efface, take yourself out of the scene and let people do the job that they have to do. Do you have that? You need that. People skills, everything. Your ability to be able to be grateful and thankful for the opportunities that people have given you. That is a skill that you need. If you see anybody who has been able to build a business out of nothing, they have that. If you don't have that ability to look at what somebody else has contributed in your life to say thankful, you're thankful for the knowledge that they have given you. You're thankful for the money that they gave you. You're thankful for the opportunity that they gave you. You are also in that position to help somebody. That ability, that people skills, you know, some people can connect with people so easily. Why? Because they have developed that. They know what to say to people. They know how to. If you don't have that, you cannot put up a group of people together to do something. And the quality of your team, you know, somebody who is managing 3 people, 4 people, the skill set of that person and the one who is managing 1,000 people is not the same. And the business is not going to grow until you can manage different people with different persuasions. Maybe you're a Christian, that the other person does not even believe in God, but he has a skill set that you need. Maybe you say that you are, especially people who are tribal, maybe you are this tribe, and so you want to work with, no, you don't have, it means that your skill set is very limited. Or you're a woman, or you're a man, so you want to work with only men. You cannot take instruction from women. That is danger. So your skill set is so much needed. It's so critical. Your ability. Somebody looks like somebody that you don't like. You don't like what they stand for, but you have to have the ability to work with people towards a particular agenda. In this case, it's your business. So who can you connect with? They don't have to be your friend sometimes, but you have some. They have something that you need, and you have to be able to connect with them. Sometimes they may even be somebody who does not agree with anything that you ever believe in, but they have something. Can you connect with them? Can you connect? Can you tap that? If you cannot, can you go beyond your biases and the ideas that you grew up with against other people? Skill set is so much important. The people skill. Can people trust you? Can people believe your word? If you say that it is it, can they trust you? Can they say that this man, when he says it, this, it is it? And if he's going to change, he will come back to say that this thing is not working. People skills. If you want to develop your people skills, you have to have the understanding and the value that somebody needs respect. Somebody needs some kind of affirmation. Somebody needs praise. All kind of things that you have to know about people. If you don't know anything about people, you are not going to be able to build a business. That's why you can see somebody, he's very good. Maybe he's a very good carpenter. But he can only make carpenter. He can't even train 3 or 4 people. Most people, like mechanics or seamstress, you know, they say, oh, whenever they take somebody, they come and they go. So they want to work alone, you know, because when they come, they don't stay, they go. Everybody who comes here 2 months, they are gone. What do you think? They will go. But can you become better and be able to at least manage 3, 4, 10, 20, 50 of them? That skill is so much important. Takes a lot for you to put the people together and lead them. If you don't have that people skills, your business, you'll do it alone. Some people cannot think of, hey, I'm going to open this office, or I'm going to give this money for this person to go and put it in the bank. How about if he runs away? Or why should I support you to rent? Or why should I help you to look good? Your people skill will prove in the people who come to you, the people you are working with, do they become better having come close to you? having come to work with you? Do they become better, or they go down? They degenerate. Your ability to see the value in people and develop them and for them to become better. Because everybody who comes to connect with you, they are trying to find themselves. And maybe they hope that with you, they'll be able to get to their dreams. People don't come to you because they are so much fascinated with your dream. No, they also have their own dreams. And they think that maybe if they connect with you, they will be able to get to where they want to go. And so your people skills will also know, will help you to understand that, listen, if anybody comes close to me, it means that they also want something. Everybody has an aspiration. Everybody has a dream. So nobody wants to become a servant all their lives. Nobody wants to become a slave all their lives. Nobody wants to become poor all their lives. No. People want to become better. And so your people scale will see the value in people and see the opportunities that you can create together. You lift them as you go along. If you don't have that, you cannot build a business. And so what if when you hear that businesses are struggling, businesses are not going as it should be, there are a lot of skill sets that are involved, you know, and it doesn't take just one day or two for people to become successful. It takes a lot. And that's why when you hear a lot of these great entrepreneurs, great business people, you go close to them. Some of them have worked with people for years, some of them 20 years, 30 years. And once they became very rich, the people who started with them are also rich. If your natural disposition is that everybody around you must be down and you have to be up, you don't have it. Because one thing I've seen about business people is that the genuine ones who pick an idea and develop it, they are so much interested in the well-being of people. Something, I don't know, it's almost like a call for most of them that they want. You see that they will send that child to school, they will rent a house for that man, they will buy a car and give it to that person, they will give them their shirt, they would want to pay them beyond what they deserve. You know, even though people will lie, people will cheat, people will run away from them, people will insult them, but you can see that call is not, it doesn't get away from them. They will be wounded, they will be lying, but they still have that. Why? Because it's that which attracts. And without your ability to manage and to lead people and to get the best of people at heart, you cannot develop any business that you think you're developing. You know, so that is very much critical. The next one I think you will need is resourcefulness. You have to be resourceful. What it means is that you have to be able to start where you are with nothing. You have to be able to start that business and develop that business. Almost all the time, what you have is so much little compared to where you want to go, but you still want to pursue it. You still want to go. So for instance, you want to maybe start this business, and they have given you a budget of 20,000, but you know that you don't have the 20,000, but you have 500 Ghana cedis. Can you start? Don't wait till you have the 20,000. Can you start with the 200? Can you start with the 500? Can you improvise? Can you just think on your feet? What are the things that you can connect to start? Because business, really, they say, is not started with money, and it's true. If you want to go in there, if you want to go the extra mile, there will always be an opportunity for you to start your business. It's not necessarily the money. The money helps you to grow the business, but the money really does not help you to start the business. It's the vim, it's the vigor, it's that strength that you have to do what nobody else is prepared to do. That resourcefulness. When somebody is looking for an iPad to go and do presentation, you want to go and just write it on paper because you cannot afford an iPad at this stage. So you just write it and you go and you present it as you are. You go with the investment that you have in you. You know, when you go there, you're creating that credibility. You go there. You don't let anything prevent you from getting that business done. That is resourcefulness. If you meet anybody who is that resourceful, you see that they are always getting things done. If you don't have that quality, if you don't have that skill, you cannot do business. That's why some people, they said, you know, the father has money, they set business for them. They have done this business now for years. They bring him there. The next 2 years, he drops everything, collapses everything. Because why? He didn't go through that. One of the benefits of being resourceful is that even if everything breaks down, you can still gather them up. Because when you are resourceful, you learn the process as well. You go through it and you go as your strength grows, as the business grows. You have gone through. You have gone through the processes, so you never scared, you never worried. You know you can grow with it. Why? Because you're successful. You are ready to do what you have to do with what you have at where you are, at at where you are. So when somebody is talking and saying, "Oh, you know, I want to start a business, but I need a car, I need this, I need that," you're not ready. When you're ready, you will start with what you have. And usually you start with nothing. So, and the resourceful person doesn't think that he doesn't have anything. Just give him the job and see. The next time you come, he has put a lot of things together and he's running it. Why? Because he's resourceful. He's able to do something with where he is. He's not ready to impress anybody so much. He's able to pull things through because he thinks like that. He's always looking at kind of, what can I do with the little that I have? You need that skill. You need that skill. If you meet anybody who is trying to start a business and thinking of big grand opening, that person does not have it. Just give that person time. Within 2 years, that business is no more because they are wasteful. If you are not resourceful, you are wasteful. Or if you cannot do much with what you have, you will be wasteful. It means that you don't know. Because business always need more than what you ever speculate. You know, so that's why you need somebody with that. So every point in time, you are trying to do what you have to do with the letter that you have. Most profitable businesses, most successful entrepreneurs aren't that much resourceful. At least at the beginning, they are much resourceful, very much resourceful. The other skill that you will need, I think, is your financial skills. You need that. You have to upgrade your knowledge. Financial knowledge, and you have to upgrade your financial skill. Business, no matter what they say, is about money. Everything that you're doing is money. The fuel that you're buying, the trotter that you're taking, the salary that you're going to pay, the product that you're getting, the phones that you're making, everything, the watch that you're eating, everything has got to be money. So you're not going to move. If the money is cut, the business is no more. Business, most businesses collapse because the cash does not come in. And so you have to have that. And the leverage you have when you have very good financial understanding, you're able to do a lot with little. It comes back to the other one. But in this case, you cannot use your thinking, the salary information. Somebody who is receiving salary every month, his financial skills, his financial knowledge. He cannot run a business with that kind of thinking. No matter how much salary that they pay you. If you are doing business, you are responsible for everything. If you just been paying, you are being paid salary in an organization, no matter how much they pay you, you just know a bit of that organization. If you started the business yourself, everything is coming back to your pocket. And your financial knowledge, your financial skill is so critical because the success of the business highly depends. If you don't go into detail, if you don't delay, if you're able to go as you speculate, it's so much going to depend on how much skill you have financially. And I dare say that majority of our people don't have proper financial skills, financial knowledge. That's why we struggle for years, you know. And the moment it hits you that I have to upgrade my financial knowledge, that will be the moment that you start to understand that you're running a business and you cannot think like anybody else. You know, so you have to study. When people are on Facebook and looking at all the things that we look at, you are looking at financial knowledge. You're looking at, you're reading financial books. You're studying. You are always, if the financial terms that they use, do you understand them? Do you know how they link to the success of your business? If they say cash flow, do you know it? If they say asset, do you know it? If they say liability, do you know it? If they put the financial ratios there, do you know it? I didn't do accounting. I had to learn them. You have to, because every decision that you're making financially is coming from what you know. Financial success is just a product of financial skill. It's only in our country, or majority of us in Africa, part of it is because we've been trained to think that financial knowledge, financial skill has nothing to do with prosperity. That's a lot of people are looking for divine power to make us rich. And that's why people are not rich, because just financial success at every stage is just a direct reflection of how much skill you have with finance. You know, so when they give somebody 100 cedis, the decisions that he makes with the 100 cedis will decide whether he will lose the 100 cedis or the 100 cedis will become 100 million within the next 20 years. It's purely the decisions, quality choices that we are making with the finances that come to us. And same with your business. If you stretch yourself, you will know what to do. So financial skill is so much critical to the success of your business. You cannot sacrifice it. If you don't study it, if you don't make good choices of it, which do you even know which product to pick, which product not to pick, what pricing, why are you pricing this product at what? Why are you paying that salary to that worker? Why are you agreeing to that interest rate? If they say that the CD is depreciating, do you understand it? If they say that the oil price is going up, do you understand the implication of it? Do you understand how the economy is run? When they say that, what is it? All the jargons that the finance minister, were you interested in the budget that the man read? Or you are listening to Manchester United? That will decide your success. The moment you say you want to start a business, you have to categorize your aspirations now. You cannot just follow the rest and think that you are going to succeed. So when they are reading the budget of the country, when they got to the tax side, did you understand what they were saying? When they said that, oh, okay, minimum wage is not going to be, is not taxable, do you understand it? When they say VAT, do you know it? Do you know the VAT rate? When they say the VAT is, do you understand income tax? Do you understand all those things that they talk about? If you don't know them, no problem. But then you have to know that the level of skill set that you have financially, the level of understanding, the level of knowledge that you know is directly linked to the prosperity, especially if you are creating the wealth yourself. If you're not going to steal that money, if you're not getting free money, grant money, and if you have to generate that money yourself, it's directly linked to your financial knowledge and your financial skills. And that the success of your business is going to depend on. The success of your business is going to. So if you see any business person, if you see any entrepreneur struggling, usually just check the financial knowledge. The financial knowledge, the financial skills also struggling. That's why we struggle. The moment we start to get our finances right, in terms of the knowledge, in terms of the skill, you see that the business starts to pick. There's a lot that we all have to learn. Even if you put it beyond business, poverty is just a reflection of both financial decisions and financial choices and financial skill set. You cannot help a poor person if you don't help them to improve on their financial knowledge. Just like that. You can give them, that's why somebody can win lotto, big one. Go and see them. They lose it the next 5 years. Why? Because the maturity to handle money, they did not develop it. So the money was just pushed on them. You know, so financial knowledge, financial skill has nothing to do with the course that you read in the university, has nothing to do with the profession. That's why people who have gone to university, there are professors who have no money. And there is another guy on the street has a lot of money, because financial knowledge is not from the classroom per se. They acquired it. The discipline, the emotional stability when it comes to money. It is learned. So finance is a common, it's just like breath. Whether you're black, white, male, female, doctor, lawyer, uneducated, you all breathe the oxygen. Same with money. Whether you know it, we don't know it, whether you can read, everybody uses money. The financial knowledge is responsible for the kind of money that comes to anybody. You know, so if I'm struggling with my business, it's because my financial knowledge was weak. If I'm struggling with my finances, it's because I don't know much, and I've not even thought that is something I don't need. The problem with most people, particularly in our side, in our country, is the very important things that we have to give time to study, we trivialize them, and the things that we should trivialize, they are very much important. You know, so that's the things that will help us to develop, we trivialize them. The things that will help us to help a lot of people, we trivialize them. The things that are not important, those are the things that our people are very much occupied with. You know, so you use every day, 3 hours, 4 hours of your life, what are you using it for? If you can devote maybe 30 minutes a day to study something financially, your life after 1 year, you'll be different, you'll think differently. Nobody becomes successful financially by being financially poor in terms of knowledge and skill. Nobody. Even if they gave you the free money, you would have to manage it and grow it. And so financial skills are so critical. The more you know And the more these quality decisions you're making financially, that's where your business is going to succeed. And it has nothing, 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 nothing to do with your profession. Nothing. There are a lot of accountants who are broke because knowing accounting and knowing how to create wealth, they're not the same. That's why you have accountants with certificate looking for job. Okay? Because it's different thing. And most of them, the only reason they're looking for job is what? Because they want salary. If they go there and they don't pay them, they will leave the place. All right. So it's a major financial, it's a major skill set that you need, financial skill. The other one that you will need is ability. Skill set that you will need is the ability to sell. Your ability to convince somebody to be on your side. Your ability to tell somebody that this product is costing 300 Ghana and can you buy it? Your ability to sell. Can you convince somebody to be on your side? Your ability to think that, okay, selling. The other day, you know, a lot of us, oh, you know, why should you go on the street and sell, go to school? You know, the African countries have so much infatuated with certificate and degrees. We like school because I think that most of us think that we just have to go and work for the government. But if you have to build business, school is important. They help you to do maths, read, write. That's all. If somebody has a very good selling skill, that person will be able to build a business without going to school. Because he can convince people to give him money. He knows what people want. The ability to sell. Sell your ideas, sell your product, sell yourself, sell your business. Convince people to part with their money. That ability. There's so much into that. And very few people develop that. They are developing every skill. Except the ability to serve themselves, to promote themselves, to push themselves. A lot of people don't do that. A lot of people don't know it. A lot of people don't even think it's important. So once he gets A in class, he thinks that he'll be successful. Then after 3 years, or after 30 years, he says, I was a first class student though. Unless the government gives him a job, he can't do nothing. Why? Because your ability to convince people to buy is so critical. If you have a business, your ability to convince somebody to, can you convince somebody to become a partner to that business that you have? Your ability to convince, negotiate, talk, counter is so critical. People don't just have to agree with you. They don't have to agree with you. They just have to know that you're also making your point. A lot of people want some people to agree with them, understand them. And there are a lot of people, when people disagree with them, hey, they cannot take it. Everybody can disagree with anybody. And when somebody disagree with you, don't get pain. When somebody criticize you, don't get pain. If somebody says that they don't like you, don't get pain. Your ability to convince yourself, your ability to, that's why if you can sell yourself, then you will give up on your business because somebody will say that, are you crazy? Why are you doing this? You went to school, go and look for a job. Your ability to sell that person will decide your survival. Your ability to tell that person, listen, these are the reasons why I'm doing this. I know this, that's why I'm doing this. Can you? Or you say that, oh, you know, what you're saying is very important. Or like Ghana, they agree with everything. Don't agree with everything. Have a stand. Let people say whatever. People can say everything. But have your convictions, have your persuasions. Because your persuasion decides what you become in this life. What persuades you? Does everything persuade you? If everything persuades you, you have no stand. You don't stand for anything. Have your persuasion and be ready. If somebody presents a better proposition, maybe you may want to consider that. But have a persuasion. And so your ability to sell is so critical. If you put 10 people there, the people who will succeed financially, and create a lot of wealth. It's not the one with engineering degree. It's not the one with a teaching degree. It's not the one with a political science degree. It's not the one. It's the one who can sell. Because if you see any business, the only reason that money comes to the business is what? It's when they're able to sell their product, sell their services. That's how money comes to the business. So if I'm going to look for project, my ability to go there and convince the people to give me the project. That ability to sell and say that, listen, my company can do this far more better than what the other person did for you. You know, that is what separates you from the other people. So if you want to get If you want to build business, and maybe you are building business, focus on that. Trade is a whole industry. The ability to sell. God, thank you. The ability to sell. Your ability to sell yourself. Your ability to sell your idea. It's not the most. Some people said, oh, good products sell themselves. It's not true. There are a lot of things that we are buying that are not good, but they are just pushing them. They are just pushing them on us. That's why we are buying them. That's not necessarily mean that they are good. So your ability to convince people to buy from you is what will separate us. If you are losing, it's because you're not able to convince and keep pushing and tell people. Those who are winning don't necessarily know better. They just know how to win. And how to win is how to sell yourself, how to sell your idea, how to promote your ideas, those things. You don't have to be perfect. You don't need perfection. You just need your ability to go, move. So when you are bad in your business, when you're starting that product, don't let that product become perfect before you push it to the market. No. Just let it go. If you are starting, let's say you want to open an office, you don't have money. Whatever you have, just design something, put something there, open the office. If you're starting a project, this is the budget. Once you hit it, open the project, let people come. Don't be perfect. You don't have to be perfect. A lot of business entrepreneurs don't have to be perfect. They just have to go. Because the more perfect you are, the more losses you gain. You know, so perfection and profit, they don't meet. It's the one who is able to promote himself, the one who's able to push, the one who's able to go forward. And so think of that. Think of that, your ability to say. I'm talking about skill set. I'm talking about skill set, your business. The things that you will need for your business to become successful. The other thing will be your ability to develop product and to develop services. Your ability. You should be able to think through what product are you bringing to the market. Are you going to pick somebody's product and give it and sell it to the market on the market, or you're going to develop it yourself? Your ability to see what the customers want, what the future wants, what the economy wants. Can you do that thing better than what everybody else is doing? There are so many business ideas that you can pick from just being able to do something better than what everybody else is doing. And it comes down to services. It comes down to customer services. It comes down to you being able to do it better than what everybody else thinks. You know, so can you come up with a better product? Maybe it's Chalewate. Can you change the other side? Product development. You have to have that skill. Can you put a whole business together which is different from the others? Yes, you don't have to just keep going, because if you're looking for perfection, it's not for the entrepreneur. You will never be, you know. So your ability to develop product and proper processes to get things faster, cheaper, and producing more volumes is what is making a lot of businesses win. It's not so much. So the next one is your ability to deal with facts and figures. There are so many people. We've been brought up in a culture where even those of us who are Christians, we still put a lot of things, you know, in the hands of God. Business, you deal with facts and figures. Okay, so if you are the one that you are, anytime you are going for the contract, you have to go and see a prophet. Business is not for you. Not the one that you can build. Any proper successful business all over the world, they have quality systems, structures, they have things put in place. They deal with data, they deal with facts and figures. Africans, we only deal with feelings. We deal with superstition. We believe that makes us Christian. You cannot build a proper business. Like, for instance, if somebody opens a shop, they say that if a woman comes to buy first that day, they won't buy. You cannot think like that. And you want to have a successful business. You cannot think like that. You open a shop and you think that if a male comes there, they will buy. But if a female comes there, they won't buy. And you still believe that. Or you have to go and put some anointing oil somewhere and run it. No. Do you think that shop right? When they open the shop, they're waiting for a man to enter first? No. They believe in structures. They believe in facts. They have data. They count their foot traffic. They know that before I set this business here, what are the things that I must have in place before the business will become successful? Every business has indicators. Every business industry has indicators. So let's say you are in retail. There are indicators that will prove that if you have maybe half of this, your business will work. If you have a construction project, there are indicators. You have to check if you're going to struggle with the project, you will know. You have to check the finances of the guy who's giving you the project, the company which is giving you the project, the finances. You have to know when they are going to pay your certificate, when you raise it. You have to agree with them when you're going to pay your workers. You have to agree if you're going to borrow, what percentage can that project sustain? And after everything, do you think you have profit? If you are into retail, the same. You have to know how many people are passing here every day. What are they looking for? If I'm selling this, is it for this kind of people? The facts, the figures. You have to deal with those. Even if you think that somebody, someone should help you, until you cover the facts and figures, nobody else will help you. But we've been told and we've been groomed to not just consider anything. We just believe that God will bless us. And that's why a lot of our things don't work out. Because we live in a physical world. Don't forget that. When you got up today, you didn't drink kerosene. You drank water. Because that one, they told you that if you don't drink it and you drink that one, you will die. It's the same application. If you don't bath for 1 year, what will happen to your skin? The same. So there are facts, there are figures, businesses, that are, those who are most successful businesses, they deal with that. Yes, you can't control everything, that's a fact. But the very basic things, have them covered. Then maybe you leave the rest. You know, the ones that human beings must cover, we must cover them. And if the business is not doing well, don't believe that it's a demon. It's not a demon. A lot of people believe in that. There are skill sets that you need. If you don't have that, the business will struggle. There are things that you have to know. There are things that the economy must have in place. You must understand some of these things. Then, maybe, if it doesn't work, you will say that, okay, I've done my part. Maybe it's not for me or something like that. But usually, most people don't do anything. And they are just saying that it's God, it's not God. A lot of things are within our control. So, facts and figures. Deal with superstition. Deal with that. People are saying that, you know, the business is not doing well. I'm going to fast and pray. I'm going to give money to my prophet. The business is struggling, and then you're taking money from it. Yeah. Wow. Some people even tell us, if you don't pay tithe on your business, you know, the business will struggle. Are you sure? It's not true. There are so many things that they have, you know, telling them like that. There are people who don't do this things, and they are the ones running the billions, and the other ones who are just using superstition. We are the ones struggling. Why? Because we don't deal with the facts. We don't deal with the figures. Where? You know, instead of you paying your workers, you don't pay them. You're using the money to go and pay somebody and hoping that things will work out. It will not work out. If you handle the workers well, things will work out well. You know, so there are things that you just have to know. The more clearly you can think as a human being, the better your rate of success. I think that God gave us this earth to control it. You don't have to be going back to God to tell you how to price your tomato. No. You know, you just have to do it the way it has to be done. And so, but it's the way we've been brought up. And so the most critical things that we need to succeed, we don't know them. And we waste a lot of time. So my name is Obindako. I am talking about skill set. I'm passionate about business. I'm passionate about entrepreneurship. I'm passionate about people being equipped to do something at the level that they are. I think that every one of us is a genius. Every one of us is gifted. Every one of us was made for a reason. And if your reason happens to be a business, why not? If you happen to do something, I don't think that you should finish university, complete college, and wait in the house for 5 years, 10 years, waiting that somebody else who was created differently will create a job and come and give you. There is always something that you can do. We all human beings reflect what we know, and what we know is what is responsible for our results. And so maybe if you change what you know, you'll be able to do things differently. You know, and so you should be open to consider other thought. Maybe what you know is not the one that is working. Maybe. And now they say that if you look at the environment, there's a lot that we have to change. Don't wait for a politician to come and give you business. Go and help yourself. Do something. There are problems everywhere. And once you do them, continue to become a student of life, a student of business, study, build yourself. And the last one is you must have that credibility skill, character. build that, have that. Don't sacrifice it for anything. Everything that you're building, it will rest on your credibility, on your character, on your honesty, on your integrity. You need that. You have to strive. There'll be tempting situations, but you still have to strive. You need that, if you want to succeed. So thank you very much for watching. Gordon, thank you very much for watching.